county, and the judge was pissed.
He was pissed.
Because they violated his order. So that put him into the ego department.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is, yeah.
And when I write it,
that's the way to do it, though.
Is there anything you want to say today about today's hearing?
Yes, I just want to say, as this gentleman has put it very clearly, the judge has stayed their permits, their building permits, and that means that they cannot do any type of building on the site. He also has ordered them to put back the soil onto the site. And I think what finally got to him was the fact that he went and visited the site. See, we kept saying that, judge, they're building. And they kept saying, oh, Your Honor, we're not disturbing the soil. We're just putting equipment on there. We're just storing equipment. But when he went to go see the site, he realized, no, this is a site that's being worked on. And, you know, oh, we made a mistake, but we don't know who made the mistake. We don't know who was the person that came onto the site. It was just an error. You don't do those types of deliveries that have big boulders of pipes and machinery to dig holes so those pipes can be filled in by mistake. That's not how this works. You don't deliver stuff by mistake, and then everybody doesn't know how the mistake happened. They don't know who's responsible for the mistake. When we know we were on that site and the workers told us that they were planning on digging. So this constant refusal to adhere to the court's order, he finally understood that he has to take control over the situation, that it's his order and he has to enforce that. And it then falls on him, and he's finally has picked up that mantle, and he says, enough is enough. Enough is enough. Put the soil back, stay the permits, because the permits is what allows them to go onto the site to mess with the site. So without the permits, then they can't even touch the site.
There was also plausible deniability today in court from those that were at the hearing.
Exactly. So I can't be responsible because I have a permit. But without a permit,
they can't do anything.
They can't touch that soil. They cannot move it. And so I'm glad. And then there's a question of how they even got the permit. And I'm glad the courts are now looking at that. That's why he asked the city to give him the information about how is it that a 2015 permit that's based on the old rezoning you now have to be able to build on this site. How did that happen? Because this rezoning is now being contested in this court. So how does the Department of Building give a building permit for a zoning that's being contested in the court? So I'm happy. I'm very pleased. Very, very pleased. Very, very pleased.
We're happy for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Very, very.